Namaste yogis and welcome. My name is Sean and today I will be walking you through a beginner-friendly yin yoga flow. Yin yoga is a slower and gentler practice where we really focus on holding our poses for an extended period of time, and this allows us to really stretch deeply within the body. It allows us to let go of any tension that we may be holding on to, and it's really just a great way to promote flexibility and mobility as well. For today's practice, if you would like to include any props, things like pillows or blankets or blocks, you're most welcome to do so. And using these props can be a great way to really find a shape that feels right for our body so that we can really relax into the pose and receive the benefits of yin yoga to its fullest. To begin today's practice, we'll be taking our right arm, extending it to the sky, and placing our hand onto our left ear, just gently and slowly, we're going to tilt our right ear towards our shoulder. In today's yin practice, for the next 45 minutes, we'll really be dedicating this time to let go of anything that's not serving us. Dedicating this time to really just giving this space to ourselves that each and every single one of us so rightly deserves. And giving this time to fill up our own cup. And when our own cup is full, we can then spread loving kindness to others. Nice and slowly, we're going to release the pose and we're going to switch to the other side. So taking our left arm now, extending it to the sky, placing it onto the ear, and left ear now tilting towards our left shoulder, calming ourselves with each and every breath. Calming the mind, calming the body. And really enjoying this practice of yin yoga. Returning our neck back to center, turning to our sides. We're going to enter into a reclined butterfly pose. So placing the soles of our feet together, very gently rolling backwards onto our back. If you would like to use any props to support your legs, you can place them just here. You're most welcome to do so. And placing the hands either on the belly, or if you prefer to have a bit more of a chest opener, you can also place the hands above us. Allowing the body to relax, letting go of the tension within our quads and within our knees. And with each and every breath, allowing ourselves to soften just a little bit more. Taking a deep breath in and a long breath out. Mindfully transitioning ourselves upwards, feeling into each and every sensation within the body. Extending the legs outwards, parallel with the mat. And very gently folding forward by the hips, keeping the back disengaged. Allowing the back to soften, to relax as we enter into a caterpillar.
If you are new to the practice of yin, we never force our shape. It's never about taking ourselves to our absolute maximum, but rather just listening to our body of where it needs to be, and then taking our body to that shape that feels right for us, and then committing to stillness. Full intention, pressing up very slowly, coming into a seated position now, taking our right arm to the sky, left arm behind the back, and then linking hands together. Feeling the sensation arising within the right tricep and also the left shoulder. Feeling into the breath, feeling our lungs expand with each inhalation, and observing the sensation of the lungs retracting on the out breath. Taking each and every opportunity to cultivate this mindfulness, this awareness. Allowing the mind to become more still, more alert in each and every moment. slowly releasing the fingers, releasing the arms. We're going to switch to the other side now. So left arm extending all the way to the sky, right arm coming behind us. Then once again, linking hands together, linking fingers. You may find that one side is more flexible than the other, as is the case with myself. And this is perfectly normal if so. Each and every one of our bodies is so unique in its own different way. Mindfully transitioning the hands back to center. Taking our left knee now, placing it onto the mat. Right knee is going to come over the top. And then twisting ourselves, looking to our left hand side. And feeling into the sensation arising within the lower back region as we do this spinal twist. And as we breathe, we soften that area. We relax our lower back and any other muscles that may be tightening in that space. As we hold in stillness in this pose, we feel into the fascial tissues being stretched and realigned, allowing for that beautiful chi, that beautiful energy to flow throughout that space. As we breathe in, we calm the body. As we breathe out, we calm the mind. With full intention, transitioning ourselves to the other side, taking it at your own pace that feels right for you. As we do hold our poses for a longer period of time, it's important that we move at our own pace that feels right for us, so that when we do commit to stillness, it reduces the amount of movement and fidgeting that may occur. Once finding the shape that feels right for you, just allowing yourself to soften just that little bit more and really indulge into this yin practice to receive that yin medicine. coming onto our toes. Placing ourselves onto our knees. We're going to take our hands now, placing the hands onto the mat, fingers pointing towards us. And very gently, just rocking back, feeling that stretch arising within your forearms. This one's a slightly different pose with a slightly different name called E-pose. When practicing yin, we do our best to move throughout the entire landscape of the body, doing the four quadrants of the legs, the front seam, the back seam, and both side seams of the torso, doing the forearms and the toes, and the shoulders and the arms. Trying to keep a balanced approach as we practice yin, rather than just focusing on one target area of the body. Feeling into the bliss as we inhale. Allowing ourselves to touch into the miracle of life that is present within this very moment. Returning our hands, placing ourselves onto our stomachs, and entering into a Sphinx pose. So keeping the arms shoulder width apart and just gently pressing up through our lower back. Once again, keeping it disengaged and relaxed. We never want to be engaging our muscles intentionally in yin. But rather allowing them to soften. Transitioning the hips backwards. Entering into a child's pose. Allowing the lower back to soften. Feeling into the shoulder blades, relaxing. Releasing any tension that we may be holding on to.
feeling our body pressing into the mat, taking each hand, pressing ourselves upwards slowly and transitioning onto our back. This will be our final resting position, Shavasana. And as we lay here, we express gratitude. Gratitude for our body, for everything that it does for us. We express gratitude for this life, being born as a human being with all of the opportunities that are given to us, and the power that we hold within our hands to contribute and make the world a better place. And we give gratitude to Mother Nature, to our planet, for all the life that it supports, and for everything that it gives to us.
Transitioning onto your side.
And in your own time,
sitting up very slowly. And to close off the practice in the chant of Om together. So closing down the eyes and placing the hands in front of the heart space. Taking a deep breath in and a long breath out, and a breath in for Om. Om. And raising the hands to the third eye space, where we have wholesome thoughts. to the lips, may we speak the truth, and to the heart, may we act with loving kindness. From my heart to yours, Namaste. And to conclude today's practice, I hope you feel absolutely fantastic and amazing from today's beginner-friendly yin yoga flow. Especially if this is your first time doing yin, it's an absolute honor for me to share this and introduce you to this practice for the first time. Yin yoga is a really beautiful way to slow our mind and our body down, to cultivate mindfulness and stillness, and also the added benefits of flexibility and mobility is just another bonus as well. Just before you go, just wanted to send you my best wishes, wishing you an amazing day, and Namaste.